ago. And in that time, we've played shows ranging in size from three people in some kid's dingy basement to over 100,000 people at a huge festival on another continent. Honestly, it doesn't make a difference to me how many people I'm in front of. I'm going to do the same thing. Give it 110%, just as long as just one person shows up. Why? Because I love to play music for people. Luckily for us, more and more people seem to keep showing up. Lem God and Killswitch Engage came up together. We did our first tour with them almost 20 years ago in 2003, and I distinctly remember sitting backstage on that run and thinking, something really cool is happening here. This is a special moment in time. If you had told me when I first joined the band at 24 years old that thousands of people would show up to sing along to our songs every night, that there would be a pyro rig shooting massive blasts of fire on stage, I would have told you that you were crazy. But all of that is true, and all of that is getting ready to go down every single night on this tour. We'll see you there.
What's up, Headbanger? Thank you very much for watching this exclusive hang with my boy Randy from Lamb of God and Jesse from Killswitch Engage. My name's José, Metal Ambassador Mangin. I'm from SiriusXM, Liquid Metal and Octane, and I'm so proud to have my brothers here making the big announcement of the Omens Tour featuring Randy's band, Lamb of God, Killswitch Engage, and on the other slot, rotating bands like Baroness, Motionless in White, Spirit Box, Animals as Leaders, and on that first position, rotating Suicide Silence starting it off, and New Jersey's Fit for an Autopsy will be finishing the Omens Tour, starting off in Brooklyn on September 9th, wrapping up in Texas October 20th. If you want your tickets, you can get them now, Ticketmaster.com or lamb-of-god.com. And there is a secret code if you want to get them tickets right now before they're on sale tomorrow. Use the code OMENS when you order your tickets and you'll be able to get them right now. So thanks for watching this. We're also simulcasting this on SiriusXM, Liquid fucking Metal, which I love. And I love seeing my handsome brothers right here, Randy and Jesse. Welcome to this cool global hang. It's great to see you guys. I got nothing but love for you dudes. And Randy, congratulations on the announcement of the new Lamb of God album, number 9 overall, Omens. That'll be out on October 7th. 10 songs on this new release. Tomorrow, the world's going to hear a brand new track called Nevermore. And I'm excited about that getting out there. But this tour is going to be really cool. I know that Lamb of God and Killswitch have toured 3 times throughout the years, twice with Hojo holding down that microphone, and once with you, Jesse, and Lamb of God back in 2013. Do you remember that tour, Jesse?
Oh yeah, of course, man. It was a great tour. Testament was on the bill as well. And Huntress, Jill, rest in peace. And we had a great time, man. It's like just touring with your old friends. You know, everyone does their job well. We all get along well. There's no egos. It's a good time. So I'm really looking forward to this, man.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, that makes it so easy because, I mean, we first toured with Killswitch in 2003 on the Headbangers Ball Tour. And I remember at that time specifically thinking on the bus, I'm like, it was us, Shadows Fall, Killswitch, God Forbid, and Unearthed in different slots. thinking this is something really cool is happening right now. This is a special moment in time. And it was, and it continued. So, I mean, we've been touring with these guys, playing shows with them for over 20 years now. You know, that was the first tour, it was like 19 years ago. So when you've worked with a band that long, it's not just like they're your peers, it's like they're family. So that's it makes everything easy. You know, we all know each other. It's awesome.
Jesse, do you have a favorite Lamb of God moment where you were either hanging with the guys or watching them on stage throughout your years together?
I had a really cool moment where it was me, Randy, and Rob Flynn from Machine Head. We were in his town and he came, and it was the three of us sitting backstage for a good hour or so, hour and a half, talking music and history and where we came from. And I remember walking away from that conversation being like, that's so cool. I get to do this, man. Get to hang out with guys that I admire and people I consider friends, and just to talk life. That's a cool moment I won't forget.
Mm-hmm. That's so awesome, man. And Randy, I know you guys just finished up two legs of the metal tour of the year with mm-hmm. your mates in Megadeth and Trivium. And this first run had Hatebreed. The second run had In Flames. Mm-hmm. I know that felt great for you. I saw you jumping off of drum risers and doing your whole thing, and the crowds were loving it. I went to the Vegas show with our grand prize winner, a big sweepstakes mm-hmm. that we had, and it was really cool to hang with you out there. You have a lot of fun on that, Randy, I assume?
Yeah, I did. My body hurts from the drum risers. It's like, jumping higher every night, and there's fire, and I'm getting older and older every day, but a lot of times I'd be like, I'm going to take it easy tonight, but I can't. I never want to, you know, Jesse, like you're a crazy man too. You're like, I should take it easy. I hurt. But then you're just like, I can't do that.
You know? Yeah. It's all or nothing, dude. It's it. Do or die.
Yeah. Probably just until we completely fall to pieces on stage one night. That's how it'll end.
It's a good way to go.
Randy, but those pictures are so epic of you doing those jumps. There are so many over the years where you're just fully in the air. Your knees are tucked in. You're like an Olympic diver or something, man, doing some crazy shit. I love seeing those pictures.
Skateboarding hops, bro.
There you go. I remember, Randy, one time I was watching Lamb of God in Brooklyn at Lemoore's when you broke your collarbone. I was at that show, legendary show.
I knocked myself out. And I don't think my collarbone wasn't broken, but I popped my shoulder out of the joint. Roadrunner Records was coming to sign us, and the owner had flown from Europe to see that show. And we got on stage, and admittedly, I'd had a few beers before we played, and I came out and said, "We're Lamb of God, let's do this." And then went to stage dive, and there is a little brass rail around the front of Lemoore's, around the front stage. I don't know why it was there, but it caught my foot, and I flew into the audience and knocked myself out. And that was within the first, like, I don't know, minute of the show. So, like, once again, Mark Hunter from Chimera tried to sing a couple songs for us, and a fan named Lurch, rest in peace, Lurch, who has since passed away. Sang for us, but I woke up in an ambulance, and I was like, how many did I was with our merch guy, and I was like, how many songs did I make it through? And he's like, none. And so the band was all bummed out because the owner of Roadrunner had come, and they were going to sign us, and he just wanted to see the band first. So everybody was like, fuck, you know. And it was like, well, Randy, you blew it. We're not, you know, we're done. That's it. No record deal. And then our manager got a call from him the next day, or called him, and he was like, look, man, I'm really sorry about that. Normally they play longer than a minute or whatever. And the owner said, that was the most dangerous 45 seconds of rock and roll I've seen in a long time. I want to sign that band. So we wound up going with someone else, but it worked in our favor. So yes, but my left shoulder still hurts to this day from that, because I fucked it up.
Yeah. I'm here with Randy and Jesse, two of the frontmen from two of the bands on the Omens Tour, starting off Brooklyn, speaking of, on September 9th.
Coney Island. Get it straight. Not just where. Coney Island, bro.
Coney Island. Let me be more specific, my brother Randy. Wrapping up October 20th in Texas, featuring bands like Baroness, Motionless in White, Spirit Box, Animals as Leaders, rotating for that slot before Killswitch, Jesse, your band. And then the first slot will be two amazing bands rotating. First part, Suicide Silence. Second part, a singer that sang for you recently on the Metal Tour of the Year, Jersey's Fit for Autopsy. And Joe filled in for you at one of the spots. And I saw some cool video of him doing a great job singing Lamb of God songs. I know it's going to be cool to have his band on tour with you guys. And I'm sure you'll get a chance to thank him in person for that. But Jesse, yeah, I know that
he'll come up and sing a tune one night, Joe.
There you go. Yeah. Give you a little break. I know you love those little breaks that you can get. Because Lamb of God's headlining, your first headlining gig in 7 years. But we're all so excited to be there with you and the band. And I know you guys have this new album that's coming out soon on October 7th. And Jesse, you guys just released last Friday a live Killswitch Engage album called Live at the Palladium. And you guys recorded this at one of your virtual concerts that you did last year and at the Palladium. And that came out really cool. Metal Blade put it out and we're stoked to have it out there. So I'm glad that you guys were able to, you know, since Atonement came out in 2019, put out some more output from Killswitch.
Yeah, it's an honor, man. Honestly, we didn't think it was going to come out as good as it did. I mean, it's live, it's not perfect, but we're happy with it. And to continue to promote Atonement, an album I love, and also the 20th anniversary of our first self-titled record, it's a lot of fun to do that. And I'm glad Metal Blade decided to put it out. I'm stoked.
Hey, Jesse, have you guys been working on any new music for Killswitch Engage throughout the last few years?
Yes, from what I hear, those guys got together.
True. You're in my boat.
Yeah, exactly. Apparently, they've been working on some demos, and I should be getting some material in the next week or so, hopefully, to hear what they're up to. But yeah, we've begun the process.
And Jesse, I have to say something here in front of the world. I love that, you know, you are a big fan of the music and several different genres of music. And you get out there and you do public DJing and you're spinning stuff and you're hosting stuff and you're with your girl and you guys are having a great time. I love seeing you do that kind of stuff, Jesse.
Yeah, I'm still a fan. You know, I never stop being a fan and I do love all kinds of music. I just like being around the community of musicians and creative people. It just continues to drive me and inspire me. And there's nothing better than going to a show and being a fly on the wall and just watching bands that are still really hungry do it. So I still love doing that shit. Yeah, absolutely.
So yeah. Cool, man. What are you guys going to do to prepare for the tour, Jesse?
A lot of vocalizing, a lot of bike riding and running and just getting back into shape, because I'm sure by that time I'll need to probably do that. But yeah, just get my ass into shape so I can give it my all on stage.
And I know, Randy, talking to you over the years, you hate warming up and you hate getting ready for tours and shit like that, but you're so good. You're so good. I know it's muscle memory for you.
I'm with him on that, by the way, José. I back Randy on that. I don't like it either.
I'm getting ready for the tour by doing something I enjoy. I'm going surfing. So, yeah, I like this last tour. I hate warming up and all this stuff. I had to really start stretching on this last tour, man. And at first I was bitching and whining about it. Like, oh, I'd rather just sit and read my book or whatever, you know, but Art, our drummer, showed me a couple of cool stretches.
I'd like to take this moment too, to remind us, the fans, they're going to come out to the Omens tour starting off in Coney Island on September 9th, that we need to stretch too. When I go to a Killswitch Lamb of God show, I'm sitting there, I'm stretching my neck, I'm warming up my vocal cords because I know I'm going to be singing. Super important to stretch and to get ready, even for us fans, you know, that are going to be pitting, that are going to be headbanging, because we're supposed to wake up.
At least stretch your neck before you go if you're going to headbang, because the bang over sucks, you know?
But I also encourage listeners of Liquid Metal and everyone that goes to shows, if you don't wake up with a sore neck and a sore voice, then you didn't really do it right, you know? So I think we have to fucking hurt, just like you guys go through that for us. We need to go through that for you, because it's the energy from us that we're giving back to you on stage, and it's going back and forth. It's this push-pull, and that's what the beauty is of our heavy music scene and our community and the fans. So I'm really excited.
Me and Jesse must be doing it right, because I know we wake up every morning like
yep.
Yeah. You guys are pros, man. You guys are pros. And I'm very excited, guys, to see you and to be doing this in the Omens Tour, following with the Omens album from Lamb of God, number 9 overall, coming out October 7th. Your second album with me, Hermano, Art Cruz behind the drum kit. And I'm looking forward to the world jamming out and headbanging to the new Lamb of God song, Nevermore, which comes out tomorrow. And Randy and Jesse, thank you very much. The tour again. The Omens Tour, Randy's band, Lamb of God, Jesse's band, Killswitch Engage. They're going to be the top two bands. And then rotating in that third slot will be Baroness, Motionless in White, Spirit Box, Animals as Leaders. And then the first slot is going to be Suicide Silence and Fit for an Autopsy. Tickets are on sale tomorrow for the public. But you, because you're special and you're watching, you're listening right now, you can go to Ticketmaster.com. You can go to lamb-of-god.com and get your tickets right now, right here on this Thursday. Use the code OMENS when you're signing up for these tickets, and you'll be able to be like, hey, I've got my tickets for the Omens Tour before you. So do that, because these shows are definitely going to sell out. I mean, just look at this fucking lineup. This whole, the graphic, the ad mat, it looks very inviting for us fans of all these bands, and I cannot wait to see the tour, starting off in Coney Island September 9th, wrapping up in Texas on October 20th. I'm just excited that we're all getting to do live shows again, and I'm excited to be seeing you guys and all my friends that I've had and supported for so many years, man. So nothing but love for you, Jesse, and you, Randy. Thanks for doing what you guys do and being great leaders in our music and great positive voices, especially positive voices. Both of you guys really represent that part of our music. And I appreciate that. And I know the fans do as well. So I want you to know that doesn't go unnoticed, Jesse and Randy.
Thanks, brother.
Thank you. PMA.
Of course, man. Of course, man. Yeah. All right. Well, thank you for watching. Thanks for listening. And we'll see you on tour, the Omens Tour. Let's fucking get it. Remember, use the code OMENS if you want to get those tickets now. And fucking surf's up, man. I'm going to go get my board too, Randy. I'll see you at the beach, man.
I would love to see that.
The only way I'll do it is if I'm rocking a Metallica wetsuit, man. That's the only way I'll fucking do. I'll attempt surfing, man. The water's too cold.
To send you one.
You have a Metallica wetsuit?
No, I say get Hammett to send you one.
Oh, yeah, I know. They should, damn it. Come on, Kurt. So, all right, guys. Thank you very much. And nothing but love to you guys, man. We'll see you on tour. Peace.
Peace.